Hey everybody, it's Connor. Welcome back. And today I want to talk about prompting and I want to share my favorite prompt, the prompt that I use over and over again, and I love it.
Blah, 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 blah.
So let me just say at the start that there's a lot of great prompting paradigms out there where it says, okay, so act, you know, in this sort of role.
Acting without acting.
And ask it to do this sort of thing and give it some structure. And I think those are actually really useful. I would really pay attention to them because if you can master that, I think you'll get a lot out of it. The things that I hate. Are these like, you know, perfect prompts that are like 14 paragraphs long. It's like fill in this blank and fill in this blank and fill in this blank and it'll make $14,000 a day. Like those to me fly in the face of everything that is good about ChatGPT, which is this. ChatGPT, when you talk to it like a human.
Like a human energy.
And not like a tool like you would with Google or something like that. That's when you get the real power of ChatGPT. And I've made some previous YouTube videos about this. This is sort of like the hill that I die on. Talk to this like a human. Now that does mean that we have to train our brain to do that, but that's where this prompt comes in that I want to talk about today. And just a reminder to subscribe to this channel. I would love that. Please like the video. It's just super encouraging to me and allows me to keep on doing this. And I really do love doing it. Okay, so my favorite prompt is what I call the wizard prompt.
Wizard.
And here's what I love about this prompt. You don't have to memorize anything. It's also super productive when you're having a conversation and we're drilling down on some kind of strategic plan or idea that you have. That's number one. Number two, this might sound a little strange, but it's also just fun.
Fun.
And I find that when I'm having fun doing this, I go deeper and I learn more and I retain more and I get just much better results out of this because I'm treating it like a human that I'm actually really enjoying interacting with. So it's gonna be easier to show you than to tell you about it. So let's go demo the wizard prompt.
Wizard?
Now we just start with a normal thing that you might talk to ChatGPT about, anything that you might be planning or strategizing or ideas you're coming up with. So in this case, I said, I wanna build an employee engagement program that's impactful and focus on employees discovering their purpose. I'm looking for a great half day orientation. What three activities should I do with a group of 20 new employees in New York City? Please act as a management consultant and be brief in your response. So again, that's sort of like a normal way that I might start a conversation with ChatGPT. The wizard hasn't come in yet. By the way, here's the whole secret. The wizard is not ChatGPT. The wizard is going to be you. This is all about how we interact with the tool. And I actually really enjoy it, so you'll see. Okay, so it's coming back with this response. It's actually, you know, pretty good. Icebreaker introductions, fun game, short team building, purpose workshop, conduct a work, blah, blah, employee stories and panel discussions. All these things are, you know, they're fine. They're pretty run of the mill. But this is where it really interesting, and this is where I really start to have fun with it. Say, now do better than you just did. So this is what I would say here. I know you can do better than that. Take some magic pills that make you a better consultant and offer a new perspective on it. Now, let's see what it says. Certainly taking a fresh perspective and then see what I'm saying. Like it actually is coming back with a much better answer here. Actually, city scavenger hunt, divide them into small teams and organize a scavenger hunt around notable locations around New York. Purpose workshops and mentoring circles. You can see right away that this is actually a much better answer. And all I did was say, hey, take some magic pills and make yourself better. That's sort of wacko. Great, now we're cooking and look who just walked in. The most amazing employee engagement guru we've ever seen. She's about to give us some great feedback on this idea. Let's hear it, guru. CISO guru. Right, so here's the thing. Again, like I just wizarded in this magic guru person to come in here. Thank you for the introduction. I'm delighted to provide feedback. This is the guru talking who just got magicked in. Purpose workshop is an essential component. Now, really what this magic guru here is explaining is they're actually sort of like more just kind of explaining why those ideas were really good, which is fine, but not that interesting. So let's say, okay, well, that's validating, but I bet you can find some ways to improve this, right, guru? Can you give us three ways that we could change around the plan? Make it amazing. So again, I'm sort of giving more instructions to our magical guru friend here. Absolutely. Here's three ways to enhance the employee engagement program and make it even more amazing. Immersive team building experience instead of a traditional icebreaker activity. Consider starting the orientation with immersive team building exercise, an escape room, interactive stimuluses, purpose workshops with external experts. You can already see here that this is actually way better, again, than what we were experiencing before. Okay, this is awesome, Guru, but I also just realized that you're actually a time-traveling robot. Okay, listen, I admit it. I keep on going on these demos. I sometimes can't stop because I get so excited about them. But this is why it's my favorite prompt, the wizard prompt. Because what you can do with ChatGPT is extraordinary. You can ask it to do something, and then 2 seconds later say, okay, you just created that. Now create something even better than what you just did, which sort of defies logic, and there's no real way that you would have intuited your way into seeing that. Now, why do I call it the wizard prompt? Because I know that the more creative I am, the more creative it will be. And it makes it much less boring to iterate and iterate and iterate when I know I'm going to do it in a creative way. But most importantly, the output is going to be extraordinary. And that's what I love about the wizard prompt. And that's it. Thanks again for showing up, everybody. Thanks for sticking with me through this demo. I hope you enjoyed it. Again, if you did, if you found it useful, please subscribe, please like, do all that stuff. It's so encouraging to me, and I really appreciate you guys. Thanks for coming by, everybody.